Hi everybody, in this video we're going to teach you how to install Apache, MySQL and PHP on a CentOS Linux server. For this test we're going to use a VPS server from Copahost, but you can install this in any server or in your PC running CentOS. Okay, first of all we're going to open our SSH terminal. I like using PuTT, but you can use any one of your choice. I'm going to paste the IP address of the server here and then click open. So first of all, let's log in as root and then type the root password. First of all, we're going to install the Apache web server. Let's just type sudo yum install httpd. What does it mean? Sudo is for the super user privileges, admin privileges. Yum is the installer of CentOS. You can install almost everything with CentOS. Install is a command so that yum installs something. And httpd is the name of the Apache model. So let's hit enter. Let's hit yes to confirm, enter. Let's hit yes again to confirm and enter. Okay, so now our httpd is installed and we are going to install MySQL. So let's just type sudo yum install MySQL minus server. Let's hit enter. Let's hit yes to confirm. So now let's start MySQL. Let's type sudo service MySQL d start. Let's hit enter. Okay, so now the MySQL is started. We must now configure the MySQL root password. I'm going to simply copy and paste these two lines here, okay? Let's start with the first line. I'm going to set the password to 123 change. So usr bin mysql admin minus u root password 123 change. We are setting the root password as 123 change. This is the same password we'll have to use in our applications in the future. Okay, let's hit enter. Now the second command, which is almost the same. The only one difference is that we are mentioning the host name of the server, okay? But we have to do it twice, so 123 change is my password. Okay, now both passwords are set for the MySQL. And now we're going to install PHP. So let's do sudo yum install PHP. PHP minus MySQL. We are installing both the PHP model and the PHP MySQL model. So let's just hit enter. Yes to confirm. Okay, so now PHP is installed. We must make sure we restart now the web server as we finish installing PHP. And they are very, very related services. So let's do sudo service httpd restart. Okay, we have just restarted our web server. Now we must make sure both services of httpd and MySQL will start at the boot time of the server. Okay, if we don't do this, as we reboot the server, these services will be offline. So let's do sudo chk config httpd on and then sudo chk config mysqld on. This command chkconfig ensures the service will be up at the boot time. Now we are going to enter in the root folder of our web server, which is var www.html. Here is the root folder where all the files are stored by default in our Apache. So let's install the nano editor so that we can edit a sample file. Let's do sudo yum install nano. Yes. Okay, and now we are going to edit a sample file. Okay, let's do just like sudo nano index.php. Now we are going to place just an example. Okay, we are going to show the PHP info function, which is a function that tests the PHP functionality and shows all the installed modules. Okay, let's hit Ctrl X. Let's hit yes to confirm and enter. Okay, now let's test our web server. So let's just open a new tab here, copy and paste the IP address, bar index.php, which was the file we just edited. So that's it. Our PHP is working. Yes, here you can see all the information about the web server and the PHP. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.